The catwalks of Milan are a world away from our sunburnt farms, but they share a common thread, a love of merino wool. A family business in Bulgaria is uniting the two by taking one of our best exports and making it accessible to the European market.
The industrial town of Sleven is a long way from our drought-stricken paddocks, but it's spinning one of our greatest exports, superfine merino wool.
It smells like Australia.
It is, yes. I feel that way too.
300 kilometres east of Bulgaria's capital, Sofia, the Lempriere factory runs around the clock. Bales of freshly shorn fleece shipped in from New South Wales, Victoria, South Australia, Tasmania and WA, stacked from floor to ceiling.
Where's this one from?
This one is from Australia. Beautiful country, close to my heart. And it comes from the New England area. It's a super fine wool.
The family business was founded more than 150 years ago in Victoria. French-Australian Eric Duran headed up its Melbourne office for a decade before bringing the processing plant to Eastern Europe 4 years ago, where they churn out 7 million kilograms of wool each year.
Why Bulgaria?
Yeah, a lot of my friends think the same, you know, actually they think, first they say, where is Bulgaria? That's the first question. Then the second question is, I hope you get paid well. We came here because a lot of our clients are in Europe and in Eastern Europe. They have their manufacturing in Eastern Europe. We were servicing them from China and India and they wanted us to be closer to them.
Labour costs are also cheaper. Taking around 18 hours, the fleece is washed, dried, combed and spun into a yarn, which is delivered to Italy and made into fabric for designers.
How long is that process from sort of arriving here in Bulgaria to...
to being in the shop?
Being on a catwalk or in a shop?
Probably 9 months to 1 year, okay. Usually.
So it's a bit of a process.
It's a long process.
You'll find Lempriere's fine merino in Zara, H&M, Benetton and high-end designer stores Hugo Boss and Zegna.
What makes a nice wool?
I think basically it's breeding, you know. I think it's the effort of the farmer that selects his animals and takes care of them.
The industry has seen setbacks in recent years, mulesing to prevent fly strike and nowhere near enough rain.
When you're in a drought situation like Australia at the moment, it's very difficult to grow high-quality wool.
Wool is typically 7 times more expensive than cotton or synthetics, and so it makes up just 2% of the world's total fibre market. But one thing working in its favour is people becoming more environmentally conscious, wanting less wastage, so they're buying less products but higher quality.
There's a lot of debate and discussion around you know, pollution and over-consuming recycling. So I think wool has a very special place.
And as long as there's demand for it, Eric and his team will continue to deliver a quality yarn.
At the end of the day, you know, we are exporting Australia to, you know, the rest of the world. And it is a nice story and it's a nice feeling.
In Sleven, Sophie Walsh, 9 News.